Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm bringing you my latest crochet style using Vanessa Marley hair. I love this hair and I'm gonna give you all the deets. Stay tuned. Hey lovelies, welcome back to my channel. This is Miko and today's Crochet Slay is all about this gorgeous Tina Turner inspired look that I achieved using Marley hair. Now, unfortunately, I did not record the installation process because it's my first time using this hair and I didn't know if I even wanted to make a video or that I would even like the hair. But I do go over the whole process of installing this hair and achieving this look. And after that, I will come back on camera and give you all the specs on this hair. So if you want to see how I achieve this gorgeous, gorgeous look, definitely keep watching. So I've already crocheted the hair in, as you can see, and I do have the mohawk and the undercut in the back. Now the hair that I use is the Vanessa Marley Braid in the color 1B. The reason why I chose the Vanessa Marley Braid is because the sections are thinner and it already has the curl pattern that I'm going for. And I did cut the hair in half to install it to this length. I cut this part already, just kind of playing with it. But this is what it looks like installed at half length. And I also have the Janet Collection Noir Afro twist braid in the color 1B350, and I'm going to use this hair to add some color once I shape my crochet braids and style them. I'm just going to go back in and just add a few strands of this just to give it some color and make it pop in the front. And so now is the time for the scary part, which is actually cutting the hair. So let's get started. So I'm just going to start by flat twisting my leave out so I'm no danger of cutting it. And I'm just going to start shaping the hair to my liking. Now I know I want it a little bit longer in the back and shorter on the sides and longer in the front. And so I am just following that style that I have in my mind as my guide for cutting and trimming this hair. You always want to make sure you trim a little bit at a time. Even if you want the hair short, I would recommend you trim it a little bit at a time, so you don't risk cutting too much and you can just shape it as you go. I am cutting a downward angle and fluffing the hair out as I cut it so I can see where it falls. And so I've cut the back, I've cut the sides. I'm now going to the front and I'm just shaping it up all around so it falls exactly where I want it to. And what I'm doing now is just kind of shaping the front, and also I'm going to remove some of the bulk from the front so the hair falls really nicely in my face and I can also fluff it up a little bit. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna shut up, I'm gonna put on some music and let you watch this, the rest of the cutting process. It's a long video, but I wanted to show you exactly how to achieve this look. So go grab you a glass of wine and relax and enjoy. You were gonna come to me, and here you are, but you better choose carefully. I'm capable of anything, and everything. Make me your Aphrodite, make me your one and only. Don't make me your enemy, your enemy, your enemy. So you wanna play with my falling for, baby, do you dare to do this? 'Cause I'm coming at you like a... And this is the hair cut and I'm fluffing and I'm just gonna go in and start untwisting some of the strands to give the hair some volume because it stands up a little bit more when you untwist and fluff. And this is the finished look. I'm very pleased with the way it turned out. This hair looks so natural and it's very versatile. I did make a styling video, so definitely check that out. I'm gonna link it below. And now I'm just gonna come on camera and give you the specs on the hair.
So I do have my iPad here, so I won't forget to give you any of the juicy details on this hair, any of the pertinent information that I know you want to know. So first of all, I use one pack of hair because I cut the hair in half. And so that really kind of stretches out the amount of hair that you need to use or the amount of packs that you need to use. I did have to use maybe 4 or 5 strands of the second pack of the Vanessa braid. And I only use a few strands of the Janet Noir Afro Twist braid in the color 1B350 to achieve the color in the front and just to give it a little bit of a pop. Now my braiding pattern, I did not videotape my braiding pattern, but I'll insert a picture here of my standard braiding pattern. And basically I just did the same thing with my perimeter braid going from the front all the way around to the back on either side. And what I did differently in the center, instead of cornrows going straight back, I just did one cornrow in a zigzag pattern all the way from the top of my head all the way to the back. And I did that so the braids would lay, because I was going for more of a mohawk look and I wanted the hair off of my face and falling to the back, I figured if I cornrowed the braids in that horizontal pattern, the crochet hair would actually fall backwards instead of falling to the sides of my head. I only knotted the hair one time and it's nice and secure. The reason why I did that is because the first time I installed Marley hair, it was very difficult to remove the hair from my natural hair. So I wanted to make sure I wouldn't have any problems removing this hair. I do wish I had done the invisible knot method on the sides of my hair because this hair looks so natural. People are gonna think I took out my crochet braids and just did a twist out on my natural hair. And I don't want them to be able to see the knots on the side, but next time, so lessons learned. Now when I installed the hair, I did install it one finger space apart. So basically if I installed a crochet braid here, I would put my finger on my cornrow and install the next braid on the other side of my finger. The reason why you do that is to prevent your hair from looking too full and bulky, and you can always go back and fill in any gaps where you feel like you need more coverage or more volume. So cutting the hair is the scariest part. It's really easy to cut too much and you have to go back and try to fix it. And you know once you cut it, it's gone. You can't put that hair back on. So to avoid that, I have two really good tips for you. Number one, take a break. Go back, do something else, come back and look at the hair with fresh eyes. That way you can really, really see. You don't get lost in the sauce is what I call it. And you can really come back with fresh eyes and see exactly where you need to trim and where you need to style the hair a little bit more. The second tip that I have is videotape your hair and come back and look at it on video to see exactly how it's looking, because when you're kind of looking at it in the mirror, you get lost in the sauce. But if you videotape it and come back and look at it, it's like looking at your hair through someone else's eyes, and it really gives you a great perspective and it helps you finish your style flawlessly. So this is all I have for this tutorial. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. I am trying to build my YouTube channel. And so if you are feeling the style and you enjoy my hair tutorials and my workout videos particularly, then definitely subscribe, hit the notify button so you will be notified when I do an upload. You guys know I will be trying all the different hairstyles and textures that you can rock with an actual mohawk. So if you have a mohawk, if you want to see that look, if you're considering doing a mohawk, definitely subscribe and stay tuned. Also follow me on Instagram. That's where I post all my update and progress pics on my hair. And you can also connect with me on Facebook under MaShelle Dean or under my exercise fitness page, which is the Jiggle Free Zone. And that's all I have for this video. So until next time, peace and blessings. Love you guys. Bye.